Welcome everybody here to something which is slightly unexpected as far as this live stream goes. We have ourselves a delay before the grand final of the Raycall EMS One Summer Cup. So we thought, you know what? Let's jump over to the team which will be playing in the grand final. This is the reason for the delay. They've got a game in StarLadder. So the StarLadder Series 6, Kaipi is going up against DDDOTA. So we follow them right here into this best of one matchup. Let's jump ourselves inside the draft and see how this will all unfold before us. I say we because I am joined at least for another 2 hours before he has to run off for his military duty. I am joined by Z Capitalist. Welcome to the broadcast.
It's actually not my military duty. This is my civilian job this time around. So I've got a 12-hour shift. You know, we had this early morning, right, Toby? We had this early morning. I sacrificed my sleep to be here casting with you, and I still have a 12-hour shift I have to get through.
I feel for you, man. I feel so strongly for you.
That's okay, though. It's definitely worth it. This game should be really interesting. I haven't seen DD face off against Kaipi. Like, I can't recall the last tournament they faced off against each other, but they're both very strong teams. There's been a lot of controversy surrounding Kaipi, obviously. And part of the problem is they do have Arteezy on their team. And he's a high schooler, so obviously there's some serious complications when it comes to most games. He's an American, and he's in high schooler. So most of these tournaments are played during European time, so you're not going to see him playing in a whole lot of tournaments, and that's why they have Sing Sing as their stand-in.
That is, in fact, Sing Sing. Why am I not surprised at all? Why am I not surprised at all? Sing Sing will whittle his way in there somehow. So Sing Sing is in fact standing noob. I should have recognized his image. So he'll be playing the he gets to play mid solo role. I'm happy for this. It's good to see him back in the mid solo because he's always been playing this high carry role back over in the Q-pad Red Pandas. Well, what's left of them. So yeah, this time around we get to see him in that mid solo role hopefully. And starting off with PL Coddle. Yeah, we're enjoying this game already. and then Bane to come up here from Kaipi as well. So heavy lockdown. At the same time, we got Treant Protector Gyro and Batrider for Divide Dust Divanya. And just with that combo already, you can already see that Batrider on long lane. The desire to kill him off being great and the ability to do so being minimal to non-existent. And then an easy farm Gyro on that bottom lane. Treant Protector is normally this kind of support role from Gold Black, and then they can give whatever hero they wanted to Bucking Mad. Normally he'd look for some kind of extra controlling hero, like a Rubick in this scenario, and with the Bane on the field and a Keeper of the Light, it seems to be a perfect snug fit.
Yeah. You know, for some reason, maybe I just had hope, but I thought maybe there was just some, you know, unsaid agreement between all the teams in the competitive scene that we weren't going to see any more Chemocopter versus Cancer Lancer. But apparently this game, we are going to see that. We've got DD. They've already got some good counters to Phantom Lancer. Gyrocopter is obvious. But also Batrider being able to lock down the Phantom Lancer fairly early on. That's really important, as well as the Treant Protector is actually going to be fairly good here. That ultimate, you rarely talk about the tree ultimate. It just really isn't that big of a factor. But when mixed with things like Batrider being able to hit the flame and Gyrocopter's ultimate, it's actually really important. As opposed to normally where you're just picking up tree just purely for that armor early on and maybe some leech seed. But here the ultimate's actually going to be a big factor in these team fights. DD, they've already got a decent setup versus this Phantom Lancer.
Yeah, there they do, man. There they do. Question is, can they execute it enough that's going to make PL fall over and die like the rat he is? That's the question I have. Looks like KP, they were watching DD's earlier game, removing out that Obsidian Destroyer. 10 seconds remaining. As far as DD goes, they still have that mid-solo role to fill in. I'm wondering, too, what KP's got planned for their mid-solo role. Obviously, Sing Sing, his repertoire for that mid-solo is rather wide. But to try that one up against Funzy in the middle lane, I'm still interested. Because we see both the Quap and the OD taken out. Two heroes that really severely control that middle lane. I'm wondering if they just add the Puck to the mix, unless they want him, but they don't have the first pickup. And I'm pretty sure Divide Estevania, I don't know if they actually instantly go for the Puck. It's a nice pickup to have, but they don't know what they're going up against.
Yeah.
And they take out the TA, so they also start banning out against that middle lane possibility.
Puck would be a really good pickup. That's even more team fight. A lot of control, and he's also a good counter to Phantom Lancer if he can secure a Blink Dagger.
Yeah.
It's really important for him to be able to jump in and hit that silence on Phantom Lancer, and after that, the follow-up, it's pretty easy to execute. But, Kaipi going to take that away.
Yeah, MV's thinking the same thing as we are. And, like, to secure that Blink Dagger is so easy to do when you have living armor to give you that buff up in the middle lane. I'm wondering then if Goblike just says, you know what, let's just screw this and we'll try something else. Maybe go for full-on control. There's only one Bane Fiend's Grip. What if they think about going a hero we were discussing last night, the Brewmaster, in this set with living armor early on? Any person trying to line up against him is going to have severe issues. But it will allow Kaipi to go another melee up against melee. They could also then just split it up and go with... Admiral Kunker comes up, and the really cool thing about this is it's a melee here in the middle lane, but the cool thing is SD hasn't been picked or banned so far, and Kaipi are already support full.
Yep.
They can't block pick him, and that's going to be so easy for Goblack now. They can run dual lane in the middle, they can run Batrider on the long, and they can run Tree Protector and Gyro on the bottom lane. It's full farm, it's full control on every single lane.
Mm-hmm. You know, I was going to suggest the Kunkka as well. You're talking about Brewmaster, and I was going to say, you know, I'm thinking about a different strength mid. And but you made a really good observation there. That Shadow Demon pickup, that's just obvious for DD. They've secured themselves a really good lineup. So you rarely see those kind of things in the drafting phase where it's just like, wow, that was a really smart strategic play. And so well done by DD. They're going to secure that. Kaipi, they know what they're going to have to deal with here. So they're going to have to think about their next two pickups. The other pickup for me, if it wasn't going to be Kunkka, was going to be Magnus for DD. You know, good hero that has a really big ultimate that's good versus Phantom Lancer. The Empower is still going to be strong on Gyrocopter, even though he's not a melee hero. The extra damage for the flat cannon is really important. But instead, Kaipi picks it up. And that's honestly, I mean, with DD focusing so much on team fights, Magnus for an offlaner, I think is good. I hope we don't see him a mid. I think they need a much more teamfight heavy, maybe leaving a little bit of control from their middle hero. And I honestly, I mean, we've seen a drop-off of Magnus's being picked for mid. Usually they picked offlane, and I really agree with that. Rubick instead they're going to go with, and that's a much better pickup. Even though Shadow Demon was that they're originally looking at, really smart of them to address what Kaipi is picking up. Rubick works just as well. No, not just as well. He works. Not as good. You don't have the extra damage coming in from that Shadow Demon, but you still, the combo is still pretty much the same, while now you have the capacity to steal RP, and that's really important.
Yeah, yeah. It was the combo we're talking about before Conker even came up, man. It's and Goldblack didn't have to, I wonder if Goldblack just thought, you know what, maybe I should be picking up that SD or not. And maybe just unintentional awesomeness in draft managed to come to fruition. But there goes the clockwork for Kaipi. So that'll be Kamomi's last hero, right? They're actually, Kamomi on the Bane, sorry. It's Bone 7 who will take up that clockwork goblin. And, well, our lineup is complete. Just a reminder, too, guys, if you are tuning in, looking for the Raycall EMS 1 Summer Cup Grand Final, it is coming up next. Obviously, DD, though, they have the game up against Kaipi in the StarLadder season. So we jumped ourselves over, and we're casting this one also from inside of Dota TV. So if you're one of those nice people who buy the tickets inside the game, even if you don't use the ticket just to support the competition that you love and you enjoy, then if you have a StarLadder 1, greetings to you inside of Dota TV. If you have an EMS 1, I'll see you in about an hour in Dota TV on EMS. And if you have a defense ticket, I'll see you tomorrow afternoon for an awesome game. And just something to keep under your noses, there is a reschedule game for the defense. I don't reschedule. A scheduled game for the defense, Na'Vi versus Mouse Sports. The playoff, but one game playoff between the teams may be happening tomorrow evening before the first defense game. So just something to keep in mind and keep your eyes peeled for it. It is very, very possible before our games tomorrow in the defense, which is Z-Rage versus DD, DD versus Alliance, and Alliance versus Evil Geniuses. They're the three games for the defense tomorrow coming out from Group B. But you could check out that Mousesports versus Na'Vi game may happen at 17 CEST tomorrow. So just giving you a heads up for those people watching on the live stream or tuning in through Dota TV, what could be coming out tomorrow. A little bit early, maybe you'll have that game. And maybe you'll have it at a different time. But I know Mouseports really want to play it earlier.
Yeah. Well, this is interesting, Kaipi. They're actually going for, and I think this is smart, they're actually going for an aggressive trial lane here with the Phantom Lancer Keeper of the Light combo. It's just the combo is so powerful that they can do things like this where you normally have a hard carry who's pretty much guaranteed to be in the safe lane farming up. Mm-hmm. This time, he's going to be in the aggressive trial lane trying to shut down. It's not going to work the greatest, but the important thing is that Bone 7 is going to be able to pick up farm. And I personally... While I think that Magnus should have been offlane and they should have picked up a different mid hero, I'm not exactly sure what, maybe a Warlock, I don't know, just something that would be able to operate a little bit better in mid game. I love watching Bone 7's clockwork. He's, in my mind, he's pretty much one of the best players on this team, if not the best. So, you notice the flying courier block as well?
This'll only work for today. This will only work today because the changes are coming. Yeah. Pylite die, buck. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. This is brutal. Bucking Mag got a living armor. Pylite die walked way too close to that cliff. And now he's stuck up there. How much money have we got on people? Where is the courier for the Radiant for the Dire side? It's actually a flying courier. But because it was body blocking the camp, it's already flying. But. He doesn't have anything else, and now Bucking Man has come back out here to get the kill. This is going to be difficult, but with living armor, it's possible. And Pylite, he's trying to sit on the edge of vision. Not really up now. He has to go through the living armor charges as well before he can do that keeper with the light blast. Oh, no, he says screw it. Do it anyway. Support's coming in from Come With Me. Pylite is looking injured on this top lane. Who cares about what's going on the lanes? It's a battle of supports. He's coming back in again.
They're winning people first.
They've still got the Observer Ward up. Come With Me should also be very careful at how close he's getting to the cliff face too. Because there's going to be a pickup. There is most definitely going to be a pickup. And Come With Me, well, he's taking the harassment damage. Because he went in Feeble, Pylite Die can be interrupted here. But he's going to TP himself back out again. But that's 135 gold of a support wasted. And he had to go back to base. And in the meantime, on the bottom lane, Jaro hits 6 for 4. And Eternal Envy's like, yo guys, will you stop pissing around the bottom lane? I've got 5 for nil down here. But this is not a fun lane to be part of.
No, absolutely not. I like the way they're... I like the plan. Unfortunately, it really just got screwed up with that one Rubik play. But I like the plan here. They're going to spam out a lot of nukes, obviously, once they hit level 3. And the Gyrocopter is going to have a really hard time CSing with Enfeeble. So, all around, I think it's a really smart play. And it's a different kind of tri-lane. It's not a kill tri-lane. It's just a tri-lane that is completely designed to mess up the carry CS.
Mm-hmm. It's a control lane. It's nothing but control. Where in the other lanes, you can look at kill lanes. Conker should be very, very careful. Where Sing Sing and Funzy, they both stand the direction of the tier 1 tower of the Dire side, which for Funzy is something which you always get a little bit scared about because you've got Skewer, but he stands his ground, he's using Torrent to not only interrupt Sing Sing's farm, but also to just deny him off. He does, he's not going to dive on a tower though. Well, not at this point.
Yeah, it's just that if Sing Sing puts himself a little bit too low, Skewer isn't going to be enough, and Funzy could just keep on chasing.
Mm-hmm. Well, Bucking Mad again, going to pull him in, then go into a Fade Bolt, but a nice illusion. That lance flown out just then took almost all of that Rocket Barrage. So DD, Bucking Mad, he is really trying to be as aggressive as possible. Meanwhile, on that top lane, notice who's completely out of mana, or almost completely out of mana. He can put one more Napalm stack out. It was too short. Batrider seriously needs this mana of his, and he's got absolutely nothing. There's not even a bottle on the courier coming up to him. Wondering what he's actually building into.
You would see a lot of players have a hard time with this lane, but Bone 7 has made it work for him. He's gotten aggressive, he's able to hit those powerful cogs to push away all of the mana. He's got a very, very early magic stick, which has allowed him to keep up his regen. He's getting good CS in the lane, and he's going to continue to do so now. He will soon overlap Batrider in CS, especially if he gets this kill here.
Is he diving on the tower? He's in. The cogs are going to go down, but living armor is damn strong. Bone 7, now he's taking up the full hits to the tower. Jolene, some space. If he takes one more hit, there goes the salve. It'll buy him a little of extra life points. 93, Bone 7. He's going to come back in range of the tower. He gets the first blood. At the same time, though, PL's going to take a fall. Keeper of the Line Blast tried to do a little bit more damage, and Sans overcommitted himself with a Quick Rocket Barrage. Living armor was nowhere near enough to save him from the tower. And because Kami had that one point up in Brain Sap, he got enough life points to be able to survive that Rocket Barrage. So now it's Kaipi up 2-1.
Yeah, that was just a huge play by Bone 7. Recognizing the opportunity, Jolene, he did the right thing. He stayed close to his creep wave, but it still wasn't enough. And then that cogs push. When Jolene left the cogs, he got hit by one of the outer cogs, and that just goes to show. I really think that cogs, that range, the range needs to be nerfed. Mm-hmm. On how wide that range is. You just can't get out of cogs without getting hit by it, which is really frustrating. So, but well done by Bone7 picking up that kill. That's really important. Now he's going to be able to dominate the lane a lot. Wow. I'm a little bit surprised. I would have expected face boots. Just because of the aggression he can put in, but he went for an early Robe of the Magi. And it looks like they're going to rotate. They're probably Phantom Lancer since he just died. They've shut down the Gyrocopter decently well. He's only has 19 CS. It's time for them to rotate lanes. Mm. Phantom Lancer needs farm. He needs to go top, and they can just have Clockwork in this tri lane instead.
Clockwork misses the latch. He backstepped a little bit and evaded.
Yeah,
but PL, he's got such a long way. And like when he gets up on top lane, it's going to be a rough lane. Like, he's coming up here now, but he's level 4 up against a level 6 Batrider. This is death, basically, to Eternal Envy. Even coming up here, he cannot stand here. Dusk can fly up to the top lane, and even if he, like, walks away. Yeah, there's the Firefly already. He wants to keep with the Napalm Sacks, and Lasso is possible. Lasso is more than possible. He wants to know it's the real one, however. He's not quite sure. With the damage that's been taken, there goes the double walk, so there goes your burn off with a Flame Break. It's a huge amount of damage being dealt. Ruby's going to go down the middle lane. In the meantime, Bane able to get that last little nibble of damage out. I guess the kill there, but I want to keep my eyes on this top lane and see just how effective Eternal Envy can be up here.
Mm-hmm. With the levels that Clockwork has now, he doesn't really need the help. Like, yeah, maybe Bane can sit on him, but Pilot Dire, he really needs to be top with this Phantom Lancer. And they can just spam the lances. After, like, 3 lances hit on Jolene, he can no longer be aggressive with his Napalm. So I think they really need to rotate out. But if they get this kill,
yeah,
bottom.
Are they actually diving on bottom lane? Silent, he's able to get the kill on Clockwork instead. Cooldown being used as a top lane I want to keep my eyes on because there's a Lasso up on PL. 5 Napalm stacks. Doesn't have a Flame Break. And he can't see him. 12 HP. Eternal Envy will live on. Living Armor keeps Batrider alive underneath that Tier 1 tower. But Envy is already forced to walk off that top lane. Lasso might have been used and Bucky Mad might have rotated up. But again, it's PL not finding farm. And a Batrider who's now 42 for 10 and is about 1,000 gold away from having a Blink Dagger. Radiant's middle
tower is under attack. There's no bigger sign that Gyrocopter Rocket Barrage is just so extremely powerful, like the highest damage dealing spell in the game early on, when he's competing against Battery Assault, which is another ability which does a ton of damage over time, and he just wrecked that Clockwork. I mean, that was just the wrong idea, trying to jump into Gyro. That's the exact opposite target you want to go for. Maybe jump in and cog him, like, backwards? Sure. Back, cog him into a Coddle Blast, and then maybe you can pick him up after that. But being trapped in there with him is just a terrible idea. Once he has his the item he's going for right now, Blade Mail. There it is. That's the name. Once he has his Blade Mail, sure, yeah, he could do that all the time.
In fact, he'll almost welcome it because then Gyro can't stop it. He'll kill himself unwillingly. Oh, Skewer RP. Dendi. Oh, Dendi. Wow. Sing Sing. Whoa. Sing Sing able to get himself a solo kill there in the middle of the lane. And also, now Jolene's rotated to the bottom lane. He is stalking. Absolutely stalking this Clockwork everywhere. But I'm surprised that he abandoned the top lane. Like, they had a decent amount of success up there before. Or were they just worried about the rotation of other heroes when Keeper of the Light finally went up there?
Yeah, I think he just can't deal with if he gets lanced, slept, lanced again and then brain stepped. That's pretty much all his health. Add in a couple of auto attacks somewhere in there, and he's done for. So, but I'm a little bit surprised that they aren't putting pressure on this Phantom Hunter. I guess it's just because of the fact that with this aggro try, Eternal Envy is really low on farm right now. They can give him a little bit of room and just worry about shutting down some of the other key heroes like this Clockwork. The longer they can keep him from being able to pick up his blade mail, the longer they can keep Sing Sing from picking up Blink Dagger, those sort of items are really key. So if they can shut down those heroes and just let Eternal Envy have a little bit of farm, it's not that big of a deal.
They could try and shut that down, man, but I don't know if you just saw the level of stacks. My answer of why Jolene is down here in the jungle is when he takes out a three stack at a side camp and goes up to 1880 as far as gold goes. He's looking so good, and he can stack up the bigger camp again. He's going to get down there in time, and that's his Blink Dagger. After the stack and the Firefly and the stacks, he's going to be... Yeah, gank it around the lanes, and everything else is going to be a lot more, like, dangerous for Kaipi. But also something else to add danger to is this middle lane. We got a smoke up on Bane, who has level 6. He's looking for an opening. Smoke's going to wear off, but luckily for him, DD have no vision on that high ground, but now he shows himself. Fiend's grip up on the Kanki, he's going to secure himself away, but Bucky Matt is here. He throws Sing Sing away, almost thought about throwing out that RP. Funzi remains there, and... What? It seems mammoths aren't pushed up by water.
He's too fat.
You saw that too, didn't you?
I caught the last half second of it, and it looked kind of weird. I don't know if it... Was he, like, right in the middle of it when it went off?
Yep, smack. Huh. Maybe, like, it's the Eye of the Storm kind of scenario. If I'm there, I'm not affected. Yes.
Yeah, maybe.
Funzi, not rewarded for it.
Man. Kunkka should have a better time now that Batrider has that Blink Dagger. You're going to see him. Looks like he's going to go top first.
They try it again. Now it's come with me. Pick up, throw down, takes the Nightmare off in Bucky Mad. So Funzi can then play around, but he's going to let off a ship. Oh, the skewer sent him up to the high ground. And Sing Sing thought he lost his prize, so he used the RP and dragged him back down again.
Yeah. It was a good gank. I really feel that giving Eternal Envy farm isn't that big of a deal.
That's not the real Envy. They pop the dust and they don't see the real one, but he's already used his Doppelwalk. So he can't get himself away from that, but we're throwing out the lance to slow down on Jolene. And he has to go into the tree lines, and now Silent trying to stand his ground. He'll have to let off his cooldown if he wants to live through this one. Bone 7, is this Batrider coming back in again? There goes your Flame Break, pushes the Keeper of the Light away. Silent, he wants to catch up to him. He's already used his one charges. Now the lasso, off on the PL. Silent, he's letting the Flat Cannon go, but he needs to see Pylai die. Pylai die jukes it around the tree line, and then Bane comes in, gets that Brain Sap off. Clockwork for the Gyro, worthy trade for Kaipi. Maybe not for how many people they brought up here, but still a worthy trade.
Absolutely. Phantom Hunter didn't get cut that whole entire thing, so he's going to be able to just continue to farm. That's really important. Batrider, I don't know. TD, they're forcing this, and it's not going to work out,
Telekinesis pickup, Dragon back, Torrent is going to hit. There's a ship coming in as well. Hits perfectly on the PL, but again, he used a double walk. You were talking about the fact like that fight happened, and then he had space to farm. What they just did there instantly stopped it from doing so. Like, he's not looking healthy. Okay, there's Arcane Boots up here.
Well, I don't know. They just blew everything. I wouldn't be worried if I was Eternal Envy. I'd be like, sweet. You just tried to gank me twice and blew all of your spells. I'm good to still keep, you know, keep farming. Staying here. Maybe play a little bit careful. But that's just a lot of failed ganks by DD. That wastes a lot of time for them.
How's actually looking as far as gold and experience go? One thing which, like, we see all these kills don't feel the balance, but it's 2,000 advantage going the way of DD. KP have brought it down a little bit of recent time, and we've been fluctuating between the 1,500 and 2.5k advantage for DD as far as experience goes. So KP, even with a couple of these failed ganks from DD, they haven't managed to lock him down completely. There's Nimbiz rune up on Sing Sing, so he's hoping for a freebie here in the mid, but can't really find him. He might just break this Invis rune right now. Yeah, he gets the last hit, so he breaks the Invis rune. Threw down even the sentry wards, then they would know exactly what was going on in the middle lane, see if they were visible or not. And that's going to be Mad to come to the middle lane. I like what Mad's got as well. This allows him to be so aggressive. He took the 2 points up in Doppelwalk. So he's now got an escape mechanism on this Rubick.
Yeah.
The only other thing he might have wanted was, well, Fiend's Group. But as far as escape mechanisms go, Having that Magna skewer 4 points in it would have been nice as well. Let's it be a little more controlling than the Doppelwalk does.
Wow, Blink Dagger picked up by Sing Sing. He's doing really well for Kaipi. He's picked up 2 kills, has 1 assist as well. He's got some really good CS. He's actually second in the CS board right now. So he's actually performing really, really well in this middle lane.
At the same time, he's performing well, though. They're not controlling. They're not controlling the gyro at all. Like the combos are still here for Kaipi, but we take into account how much farm this gyro has, the levels this gyro has up on him, now hitting level 11 after that last little stack in the jungle. And then you look over to Kaipi, and I look towards the PL. PL and gyro, they're the guys that have to man up in the later portion of the game. And PL is just so far behind. He's 2 levels behind, and he's a large portion of CS. This needs to be repaired by Kaipi and Fast, because PL needs to be involved in the engagements, but he's not. Like, even in the later portion of the game, because he put the 2 points up on the double walk, 4 points up on the Spirit Lance, it's going to be a while before we get, like, that really crazy pain in the butt kind of, like, pushing power that comes off from a Phantom Lancer.
Yeah.
There needs to be that Diffusal, there needs to be that Yasha, there needs to be that 4 points up in Juxtapose and 3 points up in the Phantom Edge. Without it, he's not that pain in the ass.
No. And frankly, I think a lot of this comes down to Bone 7. So they really gimped Phantom Lancer's farm by ensuring that Clockwork would actually have some. And he won his lane, right? He got that kill. That was really, really important. Great job. But he really hasn't affected the game since then. His gank on that gyrocopter was a really big misplay for him. Giving away a kill like that, you have to have a significant impact on the game if you're going to delay a Phantom Lancer's farm. And so far, it hasn't been worth it. Now that he has Blade Mail, we'll see. But
come with me.
Honestly, he just isn't working out.
He's got some serious balls, man. He hid inside the tree line. There could have been TP support come for him, but no, there wasn't. Bone 7, Bucky Matt, he's just out of telekinesis range. He couldn't hold him there. But Kami was coming down to try and snipe off the courier. He was giving it an attempt. And he ended up getting scattered by the troll that is controlled by the helm of the Dominator on Silent. Luckily for him, when he was moving out of there, no one was moving over to stop Kami from doing such a thing. But it wouldn't have been difficult to micro up that creep, let off a net, follow up with a level 3 Tauren, follow up with the ship, follow up with just one more person with some burst damage or Funzy right-clicking him, and that Bane would be dead.
Yeah. He got some really good wards up, though, as well. Behind the tier 1 tower, that's really important for being able to see those opportunities for Bane ult.
And that should have just revealed the smoke as well. DD just smoked up right on top of that ward in between the tier 1, tier 2, and the mid.
Mm-hmm.
Funzi's just going to walk straight into the middle lane too. I don't know if they just realized what was going on or if it looks like a misclick. Because everyone's broken the smoke apart from the Batrider. So I got a funny feeling it was a misclick. But there's a lot of people missing for Kaipi. There's 4 of them up on that top lane. While Bone7's trying to defend this very weak tier 1 tower on the bottom lane. And Blink Lasso. Thought he might be able to get the battery sold off in time. There's going to be a telekinesis follow up. There's the Blade Mail. And Silent, he takes the damage. He doesn't care, he's got lifesteal, and they'll take a tier 1 tower for this one as well as the kill. Where Kaipi with 4 heroes in the top lane, they will also take a tier 1 tower in trade.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like I was talking about earlier, it's even more important that Clockwork not throw any easy kills.
This is TP coming up to top lane, it's Funzy who came in, and then instantly Fiend's crypt up, and then stolen by Bucky Mad. He doesn't have mana to use it, and he just lost his Conqueror as well. There's a lot of quick damage that came out from Kaipi on him. And they left Silent on the bottom lane to damage this tier 2 tower. I'm not also sure what Goldblack is looking to achieve here.
Oh.
Is he looking for a... throws down a sentry ward? Either he's looking to cut a new path and just change the map of Dota, or he's hoping for, like, the best ulti in this region here.
Hmm.
Either way, it's interesting. There's a D ward. He was searching for the ward, but the ward was inside. That's what it was.
Yeah, and that was really important. They didn't notice it. They blocked some pulls. They tried, I think he blocked 2 different pulls with that one ward. So that's well done, identifying the fact that Gyro is going to be a big problem, and they can't shut him down directly, right? Because they threw away a little of that farm that they had on Clockwork, and with the tree, it makes it that much harder. Like, Clockwork had to have a significant advantage over this Gyrocopter when he goes to game camp.
Oh, trouble for Goldblack. He's been pulled back. At the same time, there's a Fiend's Crypt, which gets instantly cancelled. Bucky Mag got nightmared up by Bane. And Gyro, who's in here, but Enfeebled, Fade Bolt, that's a lot of damage. Just like that throw damage out to Kaipi from DD. Mm-hmm. Either way we look at it, it's still Tree and Protector going down for the price of, well, what was a Blink Skewer? RP not being used.
Mm-hmm.
Blink up, and now they got the man. They pick up Sing Sing, Torrent, they leave him right in the spot. Ship's coming in as well in case anyone was TPing directly onto the tower. Clockwork, luckily for him, managed to get in safely. And the pings are coming to take that tier 1 tower. That ping's coming out from Goblex saying, take this tower. At the same time, though, Eternal Envy now with his Yasha up on the top lane is causing some issues, which Tree Protector is going to try and stop. But a man who has no AoE, it's not going to be a simple thing for him to do, but Eternal Envy will back off anyway. He's fearful of the guys who do have AoE and Invis Detection.
Yeah, and if he gets caught out by that ultimate, it'd be really, really bad. So Mech's going to be up soon on Goblack. That's going to be a decent little pickup for them. At that point, they can force a lot of 5v5s. Even with the Blink Dagger up on Magnus, as long as they're the ones getting the initiation, they should be fine, because they'll be able to get off spells like Torrent and Ghost Shift, which is really, really important. He has to get that off before Sing Sing hits his RP. Now, if Sing Sing jumps in and he's able to land the RP, that completely changes the whole dynamic of the teamfight. First of all, it allows you to do a lot more damage because Coco's Rum isn't up, as well as Ghost Shift is going to be extremely hard to land when they're completely up in your face about this. So, it's really going to be up to Sing Sing to see those opportunities and try and jump in while also not being picked off by the Batrider. And that's a really hard position to be in.
Because you know Batrider's hunting for you, man. You could see him just walking around in that Firefly or flying around in that Firefly, searching for the opening. And he does have to move himself back. And in the meantime, Silent continues to farm up, now going in for his BKB. Picked up the Mithril Hammer to start with. Sees Bone 7 on the bottom lane, and then just pops the phase boots, comes in, pops a couple of flat cannon hits, takes care of the creep wave. Kalmia's neighborhood, Clockwork's actually going to latch into Silent, but now in comes Bucky Matt, picks him up, throws him down. There's the call down from Silent. I think he's scared of a lot of people following him when he threw that ulti out. Either that or he's expecting the Ruby to actually pick up the Clockwork and throw him towards the Radiant side of the base. Funzi's going to make his way in. He's looking for an opening on somebody, but everybody has backed off. Everybody from Kaipi has backed off. And this will be their tier 2 tower forfeit. There's enough support here. Oh, come on, he's getting pulled out. Lasso! It got him, and they just did enough damage before Keeper of the Light dragged him out. And that's Bane on the sidelines, and they wanted to have him there in the middle lane. So it's a tier 2 tower for a tier 1 tower. TP support's coming from Silent to that top lane. Flat Cannon destroys off the push from Eternal Envy. And the T1 tower in the mid lane, it does go down. Magnus takes the last hit, then Sing Sing blinks himself away and will also find himself a double damage rune up here on the top lane too.
That was the right decision by Kaipi, focusing on farming. Once that Clockwork ultimate is down, they can't really do anything about that. When the Batrider jumps in and pulls somebody back, all they have left for counter initiation is RP, and that's going to be a really hard thing to be able to land well and be able to have the rest of the team use that stun effectively.
Interesting choice coming off here from Eternal Envy. Instead of looking towards the Diffuser Blade, he is in fact going to go into a Manta style. I'm wondering what he's trying to break here.
Honestly, in my mind, that's just pure split push and farm build. Because that doesn't give him a whole lot. In team fights, he's not going to be able to do much. I mean, you have Kunkka and all those sort of things. He doesn't have any stats. So the AoE is going to be able to clear away those illusions very, very quickly. In my mind, that's just purely focusing on split pushing. If he can stop DD from being able to five-man push in because he's threatening a tier 2 or a tier 3 with those extra illusions, that illusion army that he's going to have due to Manta, That's perfect. He's just going to delay them as much as possible. But I'm not sure if it's going to work out for him.
Clockwork going to come in. There's a blink lasso. It goes up on Kalami. The clockwork will latch to, and then Goldblack throws out a big open ship as well. Hits over the top of both Bone 7 as well as Come With Me. And now Mag comes back in again. He's got an RP available. Throws it off. Picks three in together. And then with the Empower, with the Shockwave, Silence on Low Life, he goes back in the Rocket Barrage. He sees how low Magnus is, but cannot get close enough. So he just pops the BKB and says, screw it, let's do this. But then pushed back out again by the Cogs. He just cannot catch a break. And now PL, Eternal Envy. It's a full Rocket Barrage going off. Sing Sing loses his life, but the Shockwave still goes out in time. Force up, the Lance will follow. It gets the kill on the Batrider. And Eternal Envy picked up a double kill out of that one. Funzy, he's not fast enough to chase down Pylidae.
You know how long Funzy spent chasing that Keeper of the Light? Meanwhile, you had heroes like Sing Sing. He actually died. But he walked away with very, very low health at one point in time. Funzy just spent so much time focusing tunnel vision on that, just that one hero. Which, granted, if you don't kill the Keeper of the Light, it'll come back to bite you in the ass, because you'll see a full Illuminate hitting you from behind. But he just focused so much on it that the rest of his team completely lost the team fight because he wasn't there. He wasn't hitting those Tidebringer hits. Unfortunately, I mean, Kaipi did a really good job there. They kind of spread out. They had a really crazy team fight that allowed the Ghost Ship to pretty much not really do anything. It landed on the Bane, and that's pretty much it.
Mm. It flew over the clockwork and hit the Bane. That was, yeah. That was all she wrote. Looking for another blink dagger here in the mid lane. Jolene comes back to the scene of the crime. They won the tier one tower, but as you were saying, like Eternal Envy, he's already split pushing that top lane out. There's a lot of illusions coming with him, and Gyro is the only one that could defend that successfully. So he comes in. That middle tower also within deny range. No blink in to stop it. DD just let the tower be denied. So now it's a 3-2 tower. That's the trade-off. Funzy, man, he just took aggro from the creep wave there. That tells him there's an invis, there's a sentry ward in the middle lane.
Mm-hmm. Well, Bone 7, he just got an opportunity to farm a little bit. Now he has 4 staff, so now he can jump in a little bit more liberally and not have to worry, just 4 staff out of his own cogs and leave that hero trapped in if he feels it's necessary. They might actually pick him off. Illusion's actually going to be in the way. Bone 7, he shouldn't jump this.
Yeah, there's no way he's going to go down there or initiate on Gyro. You still got Living Armor and BKB that's going to stop him from doing anything. Because with that BKB up on Gyro, the Blade Mail of Clockwork means nothing. The 4 stuff out is going to be great, but without any kind of follow-up, it's just not enough. They need the Bane or the Magnus there if they want to continue that level of control. And that's something else which we should bear in mind too, like the BKB of Silent. It was popped because he wanted to dive, and that was it. The Cogs pushed him back. Clockwork, that's a long latch in, and he is going to go on Silent, but there's a 4 stuff away. Torrent's too late, ship's a complete failboat, and Silent's forced to stand there and take the damage. He didn't pop the BKB off. The Living Armor kept him alive. And Goldblack still got this mech charge available, and that Torrent's going to hit on Pylidae. There's no follow through. He pops his own mech. Goldblack looking for the Orb, and RP dump. He skewers out a different target. Silent, he's still alive at 114 life points. That Keeper Light Blast, he manages to evade. There goes the mech off from Goldblack, and that RP is held for the moment. It was actually stolen by the Rubik, and now with 3 heroes, the Torrent, the Nightmare, actually saving Colony from the damage. Keeper of the Light Blast, perfect, bucking mad, down to 10 HP. Pylite died, the Rocket flies, the Shockwave off target. So Sing Sing blinks up. He doesn't have skewers. Keeper of the Light Blast again, but into Invis. Funzy, he's looking for Come With Me, but he's not going to get it. Jolene, he doesn't have enough mana to blink himself away or 4 stuff even in 3 seconds time. Maybe then he can do it with the blast. The damage is there. Keeper of the Light will bring him down. How were there so few deaths in that fight?
Yeah. You notice tier 3 is gone from top now. Honestly, DD just, they lost 2 really crucial fights. That fight where Come With Me had a full ultimate go off on the gyrocopter, and then as well had some really good plays, kept himself alive with a really precise nightmare just before the torrent landed. Those sort of things were really, really big plays from Come With Me. So, yeah, I mean, DD just lost 2 fights that have now put
chance,
them
Come With
on
Me
the
dies
back
here.
Edge.
The chance Come With Me dies here. Sentry Wall's down for the Radiant side. X marks spot. Torrent will actually be mistimed. I think he felt a little bit rushed because of the Nightmare, so...
Yeah, well, he couldn't bring him back with X marks the spot when he's nightmared. So, and he got an extra level in X marks the spot, meaning you can't perfectly, you can't just torrent, you can't X marks the spot and torrent and just leave it be. You have to actually manually control it because of that extra level.
Well, it's the reason why most Kunk is never even level up past level 2 on the X marks the spot. I'm surprised why she see that level 3 in Funzie. To have the two-second delay to the torrent, which is like the stun duration, like the delay is 1.6. So it's going to take you 0.4 of a second to put, like, torrent, X marks spot, and then cast the torrent in the space.
Mm-hmm.
The timing's just perfect for it. Yeah, I'm really surprised at that.
Yeah. Eternal MD, he's got his defusal now, meaning that any hero that tries to stand up against him solo is just going to get crushed really hard.
Mm-hmm.
DD, they have to, I think they have to get some sort of smoke and some sort of gank out sometime soon.
Well, it looks like they've still got the RP available from the Rubik, so yeah, they want to use this thing sometime really shortly. Highlight dies.
They might
want to wait
for Butterfly.
That's a long time to wait, man. What's he up to?
He's got the Eagle Song, but that's it.
Yeah. That's still some time. Tier 1 tower in the top lane's fine, but at the same time, they can lose their tier 2 tower in the bottom lane. There's already push prepared as well as gank prepared in the bottom lane. They smoke up and move down. And the second they realize how many people have DD up on the top lane, they'll just attack the tower. In fact, Sing Sing's already in there. Bone Seven's coming in with an empower buff up. Pylite die. Actually out too far. Blinding Light will buy in some time. There goes your torrent again. No lift up on the effect of the torrent, but it's okay. The stun time remains and Keeper of the Light does go down. And there goes the tier 1 tower. But tier 2 tower taken on the bottom lane. And there's PL and a whole bunch of other PLs taking the tier 2 tower in the mid.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, right now you're seeing for the first time that the advantage has dipped down in the favor of the Radiant. They're sitting about 1,000 gold lead, and experience is still in the lead of the Radiant, but again, you have a Phantom Lancer in your team. If you're ahead in gold, that's a really good sign. Mm-hmm. 30 minutes in, you're rapidly getting into the point where Phantom Lancer is going to be too tough to deal with. He's going to probably pick up Heart really soon. He actually already has 4,500 gold. It's insane.
I'm wondering, is it still going to be his heart? Or does he just say, screw it, there's no Monkey King bar, do I go Butterfly?
Versus Flat Cannon and the AoE that they have, like, you still have the Flat Cannon who's going to hit the illusions. You still have Tidebringer, which is also going to clear out the illusions. Personally, I would go heart, just because of the AoE and some of the magic damage, but he might go for Butterfly. I mean, that's just better pushing power, right? It's more damage. It's faster attack speed.
We'll wait and see, man. He's got 4,900 now. He bought a second level diffuser blade. That was his next change.
Did he?
Yep. No. My oi. I told you I was sick. he just bought a TP scroll, which bent. I put him back a little bit. I saw 1,000 disappear when I only realized 100 disappear. Eyes are feeling good tonight, man. Blink,
okay,
Lasso, where is it? Thanks, man. Thanks. Well, at least the next hour or so. Then we'll find a new co-commentator.
Yeah.
Because then he's got a real job to do. Mm.
You anyway. Start paying me thousands of dollars and I'll stay here all day, Toby.
Hey, if you're going to move to Berlin, not a problem at all, man.
I think the military would have a problem with that.
Yep. So, spy? Yes. American Spy in Germany. It's now the new Dota series coming to a capitalist near you.
Uh-oh.
All right. Anyway, let's look at the DD lineup. Butterfly?
Butterfly's up on Silent. And Phantom Lancer is going to go with Butterfly as well.
That's actually what I was looking at first. I thought you'd be like, yeah, Toby, you were so right, man. Butterfly!
You're so smart, Toby.
Yeah. Calling it before it happens. What makes a caster look professional? Prediction time. Whole bunch of PLs. I love how both of them come up at exactly the same time. And they've both got exactly the same CS. 278 to, or now 279. The only difference is the 15 denies. And Funzie, well, there's a gem on come with me. Instantly into that Fiend's Grip, holding Funzie in position and a quick skewer to make sure he stays there. Meanwhile, over on the left.
They're dealing with Phantom Lancer illusions. That's what stopped them from responding to the come with me getting a full ultimate off on their Kunkka was Phantom Lancer illusions.
Not even a real hero.
How did they get there? Did he recall one of the illusions?
No,
like how did those? Did they just walk all the way across the map?
And... No. He was around the mid lane. He was around the mid lane at some point, and he popped off Mana Star and saw a couple of illusions from the middle lane, and he just sent them towards the Radiant Jungle to farm up, and then he found DD, so he's like, okay.
Yeah, I just saw him up in his jungle, and I was like, what the hell?
And more illusions up at the Ancient Stack, stopping Silent from doing his thing. Anywhere you go, PL can be. It's like he's not even a real Dota hero.
Well, look how hard he hits now. He's got Empower on him as well.
Can't wait to the change of the new patch, man. No. 20%, not this 25%. And then Medusa starts getting picked up to counter him. Caught it already!
Let's see. I think it's
gonna be another solo, isn't it? No, it's gonna be okay. I thought we're gonna be looking at another Magnus dying inside of like base, kind of like just from illusions that just replicate and surround. You remember that moment during the Western qualifiers? There was a wonderful GIF that immortalized it.
Let's see. Gold experience. It's all pretty much negligible. And as time goes on, Phantom Lancer gets stronger and stronger. Once he has Heart, he's pretty much unstoppable. Mm-hmm. Butterfly, he's already kind of unstoppable, but they can, with a good 5-man team fight, still kill him. They just have to initiate, right? They have to be able to have the Blink Batrider grab him and hit him with the boat torrent, and that's like half of his health gone right there. Just that combo. And then the additional auto attacks and you know, smaller abilities like Fade Bolt and that sort of thing. But they're really going to have to focus on shutting him down. And Eternal Envy, he's never going to be put himself in a position where they have that opportunity. He's just going to dodge team fights constantly. The rest of his team can force fights, which he can get
recalled
into.
They're about to, man. They're in between two different heroes. I'm hearing a Blink RP over on Funzy. He locked him in a corner, though. Sinksy couldn't reach him, but then he goes to the tree line and skewers back out again. Funzy, mana leaked out. He's going to try and turn and fight this one. Fiend's Grip instantly cancelled and can now be stolen. Yes, she stole Mana Leak before he started this one off. And Sing Sing's already popped off the Invis Room. Meanwhile, a little bit deeper down, Silence popped his BKB, killed off the Clockwork. A Blink from Sing Sing goes down deeper into the lane. Can't be trying to TP out, but there's too much damage coming off from Silent. And while PL was brought in, Envy said, I wish I wasn't here. Retreats back out in the lane. Sing Sing is a long way from home. He might be. He's going to skewer across the river and back out to safety, but both Clockwork and Bane going down. The first fight in a while, which we can say convincingly went the way of DD. And they might even capitalize right now. They're going to go in for Roshan.
Yeah. And it just goes to show you that even though he has Butterfly, it's still not enough. They were able to fight that pretty easily.
He wasn't there. The fight basically happened before he arrived.
Yeah.
Because they weren't ready. I don't think Kaipi were ready to have like a Jara on one side and the rest of DD on the other. They basically got themselves sandwiched. And now there's going to be an Aegis Immortal up on Gyro. Also, to note, the gem was dropped during the last engagement. So now there's a gem up on the Tree and Protector, which makes Eternal Envy's life so much more difficult during team fights.
Yeah.
In fact, there's two gems. There's one on Batrider and there's one on the Tree and Protector. Yeah.
So you get into this, you're like, oops, we made an error. Well, we'll just pick up Boots of Travel on Phantom Lancer and be even more annoying with Split Push. Like, he can travel anywhere and be recalled back anywhere. How obnoxious.
That's a good way to describe it, dude. Yeah, that's second level. Make a couple of copies of himself in the jungle and then just leave him behind. In fact, he splits him three different ways to maybe farm up the camps quick enough.
I'm interested, can you recall illusions? Is it only heroes?
I believe it's only heroes.
Cause just think if he could recall illusions. He'd be like, hey, Phantom Lancer, you wanna farm bottom without actually being there? I'll just grab one of your Manta illusions. We'll spawn an illusion army down here. They'll think you're here, but you won't be.
It's something I've never tested, man. It's something I've never tested.
I don't think it does. That was just me having a brain fart earlier.
Silent, by the way, is about to pick up his Satanic. So he doesn't finish up Manta or anything along these lines. He just goes straight into Satanic after having the Yasha Butterfly. What is commonly referred to as the Rapier build, where you have the Butterfly, the Satanic, just a casual Yasha. The problem for him is he needs to have space for the rapier, which he does not have. And that's why I'm interested to see what happens with this Yasha now. If he wants to finish up the Mana Style and then be happy with that, because he won't have a Monkey King bar. He doesn't have the damage to go directly into that PL.
No. He has to go rapier. They lost this game too heavily in the mid game. Those two really bad fights that they had, that just sort of secured that they're going to have to go some sort of crazy late game strategy.
Oh, Envy. He just TP'd in the middle lane. X marks spot, and the gem that's there from Goldblack will bring him back. Torrent timing a little bit off, but the telekinesis will pick him up, combining up with the Leech Seed, trying to slow him down. Overgrowth going to be used as well. The Pylite dies right here. He breaks him free. Well, the Mana Style broke him free, and Funzi has to retreat. He's in fact dying to fake PLs right now.
That was a really good defusal use by him. And yeah, just, you know, force some action in the middle. Nobody dies. You back up. You farm out some more. They're probably going to, at one point in time, be like, Eternal Envy is going to push out this top lane. They're going to try and rotate to deal with him. He's just going to be bottom. 10 seconds time, he's going to be teleporting bottom, farming that up. Just doesn't stop.
Nope. This is the reason why it's called Cancer Lancer. It's not because we make fun of cancer. In fact, cancer is a very serious thing. You think you get rid of it and it just comes back to haunt you and your children. And that's what that's what this is. You think you squash the Phantom Lancer and he just returns again. It never ends. It never ever ends. It's like Lamb Chop's play along. It's the song that doesn't end. If you don't know what I'm referring to, YouTube is your friend.
Now I'm imagining that we're just treating Phantom Lancer like it's actual cancer. You know, like now we're going to have PSAs. Dota TV PSAs. Friends don't let friends pick Phantom Lancer. Phantom Lancer is not a laughing matter.
Phantom Lancer leads to death. While it may not be of yourself, it can be of those nearest and dearest to you.
Well, Daedalus is up on Kunkka. That's, useful.
That's the game changer, man.
Yeah.
That's the game changer. How many times has a game been won? Back in the old days, back when Kunkka was always being picked up, one crit on the back of like your Shadow Blade with a Tidebringer, and you can destroy an entire team. Especially a team that went BTs on their PL. Not a heart.
He still needs a rapier, though.
He should be selling his magic wand, by the way. Should be selling his magic wand and picking up the Reaver, so at least he's got those life points there and builds into it. Note too, Magnus's money. We kind of been looking at PL farming up everything, but Mag's about to pick up Refresher. So we'll have Refresher from him. Come on, he's got nothing. Ghost Scepter and 25,000 gold up on Pylite Die. So we might be wishing, hoping, thinking, praying for a Scythe of Vice. And Magnus, yep, there's your Refresher. So we now have a double RP as well as a split pushing PL to worry about.
You know, this could be perfect. This could be the opening. Unwittingly, this could be the opening that they need. So if they get a really good critical and they force a good fight, Phantom Lancer may not have buyback when he comes into this team fight. He will. Earlier, he just farmed up 400 gold just so quickly.
Yes.
I was thinking, if he died, he wouldn't have buyback gold. But...
Even he can leave these illusions behind, and they'll finish the job. In fact, he just sends them directly onto the tower. Funzi, forced to try and use Shadowblade to get rid of this. The illusions, okay, so secondary hit does the job. Yeah. First hit, obviously, just nowhere near manly enough. And if that was a real PL, it would be different. Now Kaipi are going to smoke up, and they're all running down mid. Keeper of the Light is still in Alden form, so we can pull in PL if he wants to. But I think both Eternal Envy as well as Kalami just want to destroy the bottom. They're going to see a fake Rubik coming up here. Oh, and they broke it. They broke it for a fake Rubik. They should have known.
Worst part is DD, they have a chance in they have a decent chance in this game, and it's all gonna be based around rapiers. Like, if they get a divine on Gyrocopter and they get a divine on Kunkka, like, all they need is just one good Tidebringer critical. Like, right now he doesn't do enough. Like, if he hits it, that'll be nice, but it won't be enough. When he has a divine, like, yeah, that could win them a team fight right there, knocking out like a Bane instantly in the back, doing some serious damage to that Phantom Lancer, making him really low, cleaving all the illusions down. It's just going to be a long time before they have those items.
Just want to give a reminder to everyone who is tuning in. If you are tuning in here to find the Recall EMS 1 Grand Final, that is coming up next. So after at the conclusion of this game, you can stay tuned. We'll be having DD going up against Mousesports in a best of three matchup. And you'll find it right here on the live stream. As always, though, when we switch between the cups, the live stream drops for a grand total of 10 seconds and then comes back up again. But do not fear. Never fear. We always return. Always return. This live stream goes every single day. Almost every single day. Actually, no. It is actually every single day.
The chat just blew up with 25,000 gold. Which one of us said 25,000 gold?
I'm gonna think it was me because like I'm feeling so delusional right now that it could most definitely well have been me.
That's the thing. I didn't even notice it. I don't know what you said, but I think you said some support hero had 25,000 gold or
Man,
something.
Man, I'm so high on mucus right now that there is any possibility that anything could be said. People were wondering why I thought it was Mana Style and not the Diffusal Charge that got him out of there. And I know you noticed it too because you corrected me like a second later. And I'm just like...
I was subtle about it, you know? I was subtle about it. I know what you're going through.
Yeah, thanks, man. Thanks. It's not as though we're running a fever in here while we've got the aircon down at like 15 degrees. I'm like, oh, it's so hot. It's so hot. Fetal position in the corner. It's Lancer. It's Lancer. It's Lancer. Get rid of the Lancer. Get rid of the Lancer.
Oh, you're gonna have some serious fever dreams,
man,
going on soon.
You don't want to know. You don't want to know what my imagination does at night. It is not cool, man. When you wake up from a good night and you think, yeah, I've had a good night's sleep, and you're more tired than you were when you went to sleep. You're like, oh, yeah. My imagination runs marathons. Funzy, what a double walk. They chase up PL Illusions. There's already the Lance out to Bucking Mad. And now the Overgrowth. Who are they searching for? It's just Eternal Envy killing off Goldblack. Meg Charge will keep him alive. The Illusions will follow through on him. I'm hearing an RP off to the side. It looks like they got both the BKB heroes. And then again, wasting the entire time of the BKBs. And then Bone 7. The Cogs push Jolene out. Silent's going to remain in here, just basically letting up any damage he can, while Kaipi, still on the higher ground, basically laughing cynically as Silent just gets destroyed off by Eternal Envy. Keeper of the Light Blast. It's a triple kill for the Lancer of Phantoms. And 45 minutes in, they may go for just a GG push down the middle lane.
Yeah. Honestly, like I said, there's a small chance that DD could win this. Pushed late enough with enough divines, you know, anything can happen in late game. Phantom Lancer's maxed out. Like, yeah, you can sell your treads, but for the most part, Phantom Lancer is maxed out. There's no reason not to push this. There's no reason to let DD catch up in gold in any regards. Clockwork, he has an Aghanim's. That'll be a nice little pickup for him. But I expect in the next... I mean, is Roche up? He might wait
for
Roche, but...
Eternal Envy is taking top racks by himself, man. He waits for no man. Once he's got farm, once he's finished farming, he'll just go. Sends another illusion back in there again. And the Rax, it's actually going to go down to these three. That's why Telekinesis is forced to be used. And the Rax, he got it. He got it. With Mana Style Illusions and a Double Walk Illusion after his initial damage, the Rax is gone. The entire top Rax is gone in favor of a Phantom Lancer who now has another 4,000 gold. Also, could be mistaken for 40,000, but just 4,000 gold.
Yeah, I'm just imagining what kind of fever dreams you're gonna be having tonight. Like, I just keep imagining you see this blue cat man with a white beard. You blink and all of a sudden there are 10 of them surrounding you. Meanwhile, there's this faint going on in the background.
Sad thing is that you just have a cat's face there, and the cat's face is just singing it, and all you hear is Silent is dead. And Envy is there.
Oh, dear.
Anything is possible in the imagination, man, especially when you got a warped one. Fonzie's sitting there in an invis room in the middle lane. He's really hoping for any kind of extra blood he can spill. Mithril Hammer sitting there. Come with me. It's a Fiend's Grip. It's stolen. Fiend's Grip is stolen. He just leaves him there. He takes the grip and says, Fonzie, it was really nice knowing you, man, but you got no chance of getting out of that one alive. I will take the ability and run.
I have never seen a bigger ditch in a competitive game in my life. He's just like, hey, good bait. I took the Bane ultimate. Appreciate
it. Yep.
See ya.
That's the way to control a Phantom Lancer. Remember Hani's advice. Don't deal with all the PLs. Deal with PL. That's the advice to dealing with a Phantom Lancer. And the funny thing is, it's a split push. Envy goes in through the bottom, while the rest of Kaipi go in through the mid. So he's already taken the tier 3 tower on the bottom lane. They haven't had time to respond to him. He has a mana style up and running. He takes it out, the flame break goes, and there goes Clockwork. That is a huge lash to Bucking Mad. He's like, don't worry, I got Fiend's Grip. We can defend this. No, we can't. The bottom racks is gone. DD cannot stop this PL. By the time they rotate, it's already too late. And the PL illusions are going to continue to kill off. Yeah, Bucking Mad. No, he's okay. But the top lane is pushing in, and it's Roshan again.
You remember that one game that we casted together? Exciting Dota, Blue Balls, etc. Where there was no kills for so long.
Oh yeah, I remember that.
And
that
was it Mouse? Mouse won the game without forcing a team fight. It was just a base race that ended.
Yep.
Hashtag, just a little bit trollier.
Hashtag Exciting Dota.
Yeah.
That's what it's all about, man.
This is exactly what it is, except for it's not even the excitement of a base race. This is just like, illusions killing towers, illusions killing barracks, and there's nothing DD can do about it.
But DD aren't giving up, man. I think they still have, like, they're investing into this rapier ideal. He has a demon edge. He needs another, what is that? Do the math for me. 1,600? 1,600 gold? Yeah. Shows you how bad my brain is if I can't actually add 1,600 to 2,200 and get 3.8k.
It's okay, I wasn't listening to you.
Thanks, man.
You're like, do the math for me, and I'm like, oh, what math is he talking about?
There's a Monkey King bar. He just bought a Monkey King bar. It's all Silent Fields he can do. At least now he can finally pick off these PL illusions when they push in. But at the same time, Abyssal Blade was just purchased up by the Phantom Lancer. He just keeps sending in the Doppelwalk illusions. One by one, he attacks on the tower. This almost feels like a lone druid push.
Yeah.
It's just like, we don't have to sacrifice anything that's real. Just pop the mana style, goes off in 1 second, throws a lance out, so now he's got two of himself. More tower to push. Looking to latch in, and there goes Clockwork. Hit Goblack perfectly. Four-star away and gets himself away from those cogs. Jolene will pop up the BKB. Blink Dagger in 1 second time. RP, it was attempted. Now it does go off. Sarn and Goblack caught. Refresher Orb not going to happen when Bucking Mad. This time he used that Fiend's Grip. Well stolen. Overall, but Envy, he's back in the base. He's taking the damn racks. He's forcing it to Mega Creeps. They've got to kill up this PL, and they get him. DD defend against PL. They hold their range racked by about 270 life points, regenerating quickly. And then PL will buy back, and he's got BTs. Why is he walking?
He needs to farm some more.
Ah, of course. Sorry.
It wasn't bad enough spending 50 minutes of farm time just so he could not fight anything but hit Rex. You notice the kill count? Kaipi is still at 19 kills, the same kills that they've been at for quite some time.
Nah,
it's because
good.
That team fight, quote unquote, team fight, was just a distraction. It was all just a distraction, so Phantom Lancer could PvE his way through buildings.
Look at this hand! Look at this hand! Look at this hand! You got no buildings.
God damn it. Oh. Like, what's the point of getting a bash, abyssal? Like, it's good damage. Well, what's the point of getting an abyssal if you're just gonna hit buildings? You can't bash buildings, if that's your whole job in life. Oh, he might as well gone Deso. At least he has a minus armor for hitting buildings.
Hey, man, you know what? I'm still here at this point saying that DD will win. And I'm gonna say that because I love an underdog. All Australians love underdogs. DD will group up together. They will take the best fight of their life. Funzy, look at how secure he's being. He X marks to spot himself so he can come out and deadless down the creep wave. But he's on his way to a BKB. He's on his way to a BKB. Gold Black has got the potential for the best ultimate of his life. You're then going to Bucking Mad that will has already stolen Spirit Lance. So he's going to now turn PL's power against him. And you got Gyro with 2,100 gold up his sleeve. By the time KP push in, he'll have enough money for a Divine Rapier. And then we're just going to see, like, GG calls coming off from Kaipi as they realize that, obviously, they just weren't strong enough.
Oh, God. Kaipi, yeah, Eternal of Envy, he needs to change his name.
No,
building chopper.
Everyone is envious of him, so he is the Eternal Envy.
I'm not envious of him.
Really? If you had a PL that farmed up, you could never lose a game with a PL that's that farmed up. I think you'd be envious, man. I really think you'd be envious.
I would feel dirty after winning the game like this.
It's just... Well... It's no, no. Imagination! Just stop. It's not fair. Look at these illusions. They're going in for the racks. The pings came past. It's like Flame Break. Firefly. What else do we need? Nothing. Black Cannon's enough. Okay. We got this, boys. 2,700. I'm watching Silence Gold. I'm watching Silence Gold above anything. Because Eternal Envy, he's getting so much cash, and none of it's going to do him any good. He can buy back and BT himself back in again. So technically, this is going to be like a 6-on-5 engagement coming up. But at the end of the day, if Gyro can continue to do that damage and then pop the Satanic at the right time, it won't matter. Look at him. He's out in the top lane. We're getting closer, man. 3k gold.
Kill me now.
No. Live.
Got
survive.
Away from buyback, guys. BRB. BRB 6 minutes.
Hang on. No. I'm just going to go on Gyrocam. Drinks break, peoples. Drinks break.
Oh, my God. BKB is picked up on Kunkka. This is a game-changing item that will allow DD to... I can't do it. I can't say it. It's just...
All right, my drinks break's over.
Watch what happens. It finally happens, right? They finally can take the range rags, and they finally... Oh, look, we've got Mega Creeps, ha-ha-ha. And then Kaipi is going to back up and farm some more. They're just going to let DD try and defend against Mega Creep. And I wouldn't be so mad, but I had time. We had 2 hours. 2 hours to get two games. I thought that would be good enough. But with this game... I'm like, going to have to leave halfway through the next game if you don't have a co-caster.
Yeah, it's true, man. It's true. Taking applications for co-casters in the next minute. Not really. 3,400 up on Gyro. It's a full 5-man push from Kaipi coming in the middle lane now. They are here. Bone 7 is just waiting for the best opportunity of his life. Unfortunately, he's blocked by PL Illusion. But it's okay. Silence still defending the bottom lane. He's going to buy back. There's the Latchin. He goes on Sun, the 4-stop away. It's a fake. Look at the middle lane. Gold Black goes down. The PL is there. They've got to kill him off. An RP from Sing Sing. Finally, they hold him there. A secondary RP. Fiend Grip on Silent. All the control in the world. Buyback from Silent will come. This Rain Drake is still alive. It's still alive. The RP was stolen and it bought some time. Gyro being initiated on again. They will kill off the rack. They do. They can. They do. Eternal Envy is looking for the opening. He'll come down to Bucky Matt, he finds Silent, he goes the Abyssal Blade, and there goes the Skewer Throw BKB target. Obviously not going to work, but this will be the GG call coming off finally. Diffusal Blade goes up to Jolene. Eternal Envy throws more lances so he can fight with more of himself. And they will, eventually, Clockwork latches in. They're going for the dive, they're going for the kills. Batrider disappearing underneath the map for a short moment before finally being lanced. No, he's actually going to live. GG is called out by Bucky Matt. End this madness. That's the wrong target to lasso, but still, he couldn't know. GG, 56 minutes. I applaud this game. May we have more of this, Dota. TI3 Grand Final coming to you from a PL soon.
So, I mean, real talk, this is Kaipi. They played the strategy right. And even when they had a significant advantage, they still held the strategy all the way through mm-hmm. to its conclusion, which was avoiding team fights and farming. And they did the right things. Too bad those things make for frustrating Dota to watch. Yeah. But, you know.
Yeah, we joke around because we want to make it so you guys don't just sit there beating your head against a brick. But at the end of the day, it's a strat. It's a strat mm-hmm. that works. And while it works, you can't say, you know what, KP? You played a bad game of Dota. Because they played a good game of Dota. They knew what they had to do. They waited for it out. They didn't go Game of Throws. And because of that, you can't say, you know what, let's dedicate a website called Game of Throws to them. It doesn't happen that way. They play a good game of Dota and they wrap it up. We're going to wrap up this game right now, but stay tuned. The game of our last game of the night, best of three, coming up to you shortly will be DD going up against Mouseports in the Raycall EMS 1 Summer Cup number 3 Grand Final. So stay tuned. We'll be back here in just a couple of moments. Live stream will drop, but it will be back in like 60 seconds after the drop. So stay tuned. See you soon.